rural mountainous area of Western Macedonia, Greece, once provided over 50% of the Greek total energy production. But by 2028, all lignite mines will be closed, crucial for the climate, but with a high risk for unemployment and a regional GDP decline. One new income source is smart agriculture and clean energy production. Third-generation farmer Yannis Mpisiritsas manages a farm with livestock and an adjacent biogas plant, built in 2017.
The benefits are both environmental and economic. We are helping to reduce greenhouse gases, we process the waste, new jobs are created. It is an extra income for our company, as well as for the surrounding area.
Biogas plants are mainly fed by the remains of livestock like pigs and cows. The products, biogas for the generation of electricity, as well as liquid and solid waste.
Inside there, we have a constant temperature of 40 degrees Celsius. This is where anaerobic digestion takes place. The wastewater stays in the digester for about 40 days. From there, they are taken to the separator, where liquids and solids are separated, and then they end up in the fields with motor vehicles.
Currently, most of the European biogas plants just spray the liquid digestate as fertilizer on their fields. But this routine has some severe side effects, and researchers are taking action to combat those.
What comes with a biogas plant is a remaining liquid that has some nutrients. If you continuously, without processing this liquid, discharging this as a means of irrigation, the nutrients, especially nitrogen, can cause an effect which is called nitrification of the soils. And this is detrimental for the health of the soils. You're also introducing antibiotics that are not destroyed.
Kyriakos Panopoulos is coordinating the European research project NOMAD, which developed a mobile solution for decentralized and small-scale biogas plants in rural areas to process the leftover digestate into high-quality organic byproducts and turning the residual water safe for irrigation.
The NOMAD project is around a circular economy in the agricultural regions. It stems from the operations of biogas plants and makes use of the digestate, the remain of the biogas plant treatment. It produces fertilizers, clean water, and also removes antibiotics from the remaining effluents.
How this is done? By state-of-the-art technology, a combination of different filtering techniques, disinfection steps, and a nutrient recovery section. Here, at the Center for Research and Technology Hellas, CERTH, Konstantinos Plakas worked mainly on the development of the nutrient recovery section. But before that, all suspended solids and other large deposits have to be separated from the digestate using different membrane processes.
This is a porous ultrafiltration membrane in form of hollow fibers. They look like spaghetti. You cannot see it with your bare eye, but they do have pores here. They have a size of close to 30 nanometers, the specific membrane modules. So particles that are larger than 30 nanometers of their size, they are retained out of the membrane while the clean water passes through. And we use it, this specific technology in a NOMAD 2 track, to pretreat the anaerobic digestate in order to retain solid suspended particles up to a size of close to 1 micrometer.
After the membrane filtration, the new selective electrodialysis process is applied to separate different ions, thereby recovering valuable nutrients out of the digestate, which are later used as liquid and solid fertilizer and soil amenders.
By this way, we can fractionate in different streams the target nutrients, such as the ammonium ions, together with the potassium. In a different stream, we call it cationic product. Okay, we can have the ionic product, where we selectively separate the phosphates together with the sulfates. And we have also the brine, where we have the chlorides and other species that have not been effectively separated. And the pure stream, the pure water that can be effectively reused as an irrigation water to the farmers.
Next to the filtration process, a novelty of the NOMAD truck is to implement ozonation as a disinfection method. This was developed by the NOMAD partners at the IHE Delft Institute for Water Education in the Netherlands. Chemist Nazanin Moradi is an expert for the removal of pharmaceutical active compounds from treated sludge.
If the antibiotic discharges to the environment, then in long time it produces antibiotic resistance genes and bacteria. And once again, we will see in the future that actually people are dying with a simple infection because antibiotic doesn't work to treat the disease anymore.
In fact, there is no regulation for antibiotic discharge to the environment yet, but it is an important global issue, as 46% of the global waste produced is organic waste, like manure or food, which can contain antibiotic residues.
Ozonation is very successful in removing of this antibiotic. We fill the reactor of ozonation with the liquid part of the digestate, and then ozone, through direct and indirect mechanism, attacks the target compounds. So the parent compound of the antibiotic that we have, it degrades and breaks down to smaller molecules.
Those laboratory tests are now transferred to field trials in Italy, Malta, the UK and Greece. Here, the NOMAD truck works as a mobile digestate treatment facility, combining all developed technologies. The antibiotic removal is performed by a UVOX machine using UV light and ozone. The end products are clean water for irrigation and recovered nutrients to produce fertilizers. To prove the produced solid and liquid fertilizer, the researchers are cooperating with partners on location. Kyriaki Sakilariou from the official waste management body of the region of Western Macedonia, Diadima, is putting the NOMAD products to a real-life test.
The main goal of these trials is to evaluate the performance of the different materials coming out of the NOMAD truck and be compared with commercial materials in order to see how they affect the growth of lettuce.
One special interest of Kyriakis using the NOMAD fertilizer and soil amender is the effect on the degraded local soils deriving from the old lignite mines.
The open field, which we will use for the trials, is an old lignite mine. So we have used the soil of this place in the pots for the trials. And this is interesting for the whole region here, because now that the lignite mines are about to close, the restoration of these mines is a matter that concerns the local community. So if we can use the land of the old mines for cultivation, not only for aromatic plants or other types of trees and plants, but also for plants that are consumable like lettuce, will be very important.
The upcoming months will show whether the dream of Kyriaki for the Western Macedonian soil is coming true. But already now, the researchers are sure the NOMAD truck has a great impact on farms in remote locations.
It's a game changer because it's really integrating all the different technologies necessary to produce clean water, which is very, very important. It's very important to have natural biofertilizers locally produced. We hope to see in the next years the replication of this technology in rural areas across Europe. But it can also be applied in other regions, such as in Africa and Asia.